everybody, buying a wild Armenian rat ride carport, builder, mechanic, real estate investor, carport mechanic, whatever you want to call me. Don't call me late for lunch. Hey, and it's afternoon. Man, I just went on a nice road trip to Williston, Florida. Old Ed Salvage Yard had old collector cars, and unfortunately, old Ed is scrapping everything out. About broke my heart. Oh, Lord. Oh, old Detroit Steel getting crushed, going to the scrapper. He's got some stuff at his house. He invited me over there. I don't think I'll do it this Sunday, but maybe next Sunday or a couple of Sundays from now, go check out with his collection at his house. And so I'm looking forward to that. I'm going to go to another salvage yard in Gainesville, Florida, called Roadside Relic. And he's only open on Wednesday, so I'm hoping I can get a fender for my 51-52 Ford truck. And that's what year. It's a 54. I don't mean to confuse you here, but I'm putting a front 51-52 Ford clip on. I like that with the shark teeth in the front. I love that. So, but I'm looking for a fender, so that's what I'm doing. But anyway, that's not why I'm making this video. A little backstory to y'all tuning in for the first time. Welcome, and welcome to my subscribers. It's been with me. Really do appreciate you folks hanging in there with me and giving me the support and helping out my little small channel here. You know, and a little backstory again, like I said, I retired at age 65. I could have retired legally at 62. That was, you know, my legally, I could start collecting Social Security, and I would have loved to, but I had colon cancer about 13 years now, and I had a Blue Cross Blue Shield insurance, and I just didn't want to take a chance of going on to Obamacare or Cobra insurance, and you know, and just, I was kind of planning in there. Plus, the longer you wait with Social Security, the more you'll make, you know. So, you know, and I keep saying I'm going to do this, and forgive me, I got some old, I'll have to go back to the notes of my Social Security notes that I've done over the last, geez, I'm going to say, oh, good 3 years, I was counting, I was doing, crossing the T's and, you know, and adding up what I could make if I weighed it and that kind of stuff. Of course, now let me tell you something. 65 is not my full retirement age. Actually, it's 66 and 8 months. And of course, 70 is the full enchilada. And let me tell you, you know, here's what I think. I believe my health. Now, the other day I had an asthma attack and I was sitting in church. And I'm thinking to myself, I was seeing stars, and because the oxygen to my brain, you know, of course, and I thought, you know, if I die, this is a perfect place to die. It's in a church, you know, I mean, really, you know, I'm not kidding you. That's how bad I felt and how bad of an asthma attack I had. And, you know, and luckily today, thank God, I'm doing a lot better, breathing a lot better. And, but, you know, here I am, I'm 65, and I don't know where I'll be when I'm 70 years old. You know, will I have an oxygen attack? You know what I'm saying? I hope not. But, you know, I don't know. Had I keep working, and I was working around a lot of farm implements and equipment and diesel engines, and that diesel smoke, I mean, for some reason, the emissions off of diesel trucks set me off. And even toast in a toaster, when it starts burning, for some reason, I'll start hacking. I mean, I don't know why. I don't know why. I can be around these rat rides or whatever, and they don't bother me. there I go again. Excuse me. And, or build a fire or something, that won't bother me. But I mean, diesel. Woo! So yeah, I don't know where I'd be in, you know, if I was 70 years old. So like I said, I wish I could have took it earlier, but it worked. You know, it is what it is, and it worked out. I'm not going to suggest what to do for you. I mean, I can just suggest. I mean, what I'm saying, I'm not going to tell you. I'm not a Social Security agent, or I'm not a CPA or anything like that. You got to do what fits for you. But if you got a whole pile of money, and just, you know, think about it. Really think about it. You know, life is great being retired. and do it if you can with your younger and healthier. I mean, really, and I'm testament to that, and I'm going to say it, you know, well. But, you know, and I was thinking my reason of this video today is my money says, you know, that's what the topic is. My money says, too, but it says in God we trust. And I was thinking about that, you know, in over the years, you know, I've saved diligently. I know there was a time I went through divorce and bankruptcies and I felt dirt poor. And I never thought I'd see the day that I'd actually retire and do it pretty comfortably, you know? And that's a miracle. And but I believed in some stuff. There was a Christian ministry, Larry Burkett, in Atlanta, Georgia area. And I listened to his ministry for years. And, you know, I bought some books and I listened to him a lot. And it talked about being a good steward to your money. And that's when things started turning around with me. And it didn't happen overnight. You know, I never want to mislead anybody. When I talk about stuff, you know, nothing happens overnight. But, you know, you keep your eye on the prize and keep straight and narrow on stuff and make a decision. Once you make that decision, it will happen. It's not going to happen overnight. There's going to be struggles in life, like I said, you know. I had cancer and suffered divorce and bankruptcies and stuff like that and all kinds of, you know, but I persevered through it all. And my money, which a lot of times, I used to say this a lot, I said, the day they start taking and God we trust off of our money, we're going to be in trouble. And I found out by researching Dwight Eisenhower had Congress, I think he rallied for this, and they put that on the bill, and I was surprised. I always thought it had it, but actually it used to say God our trust on our money, and that was before, 1957, I think is what they did it, so in the, let's say mid-50s, that's when they changed it into God we trust, and so that's wild. I didn't know that, God our trust. And I'd like to, now I'm starting to like to go to some old coin shops and stuff like that, start looking at some old currency and look at it. And it's interesting, very interesting. I read up on it, and it's really wild about what I found out about our currency. And of course, in the Civil War, they actually, I think Congress did start putting that in God we trust, but it was in God our trust. And like I said, in the 50s, Dwight D. Eisenhower, they put it into law, and that's what's on your currency today. Now, with Muslims and other people in this country, I don't know, there's been talk about changing it. I don't know, but I was reading on and on. It was late last night, and I didn't get too far into that. But, you know, and then we're going into digital currency, and, you know, what is digital currency? We all got digital currency, basically. Now, tomorrow I'm going to go to Roadside Relic, I said. Now, I don't have, if I'm lucky, I might have $50 in cash on me, okay? There's some days I might have $5, but I got the money in the bank, okay? So, basically, my money's digital, I guess, if you really want to say it. I mean, I just can't go grab the, you know, and if I have to get large sums of money, I'm talking probably over 5 grand to 10 grand. I think it's actually 10 grand. I have to order it, basically. Anything, I believe it's 10 grand that I have to order. And because I think not too long ago, I got 5 grand out and they didn't have a problem, I'm pretty sure. And but yeah, 10 grand, I have to order it or more, you know, of course. And usually when you buy property, this past year we bought property, everything was done electronically, you know, sold one piece, bought another piece, that whole one week went to closing twice, you know, and I never sold the money. And I trust that the process went through. And that's it too, you know, with people. And like today, you know, when I go to that salvage yard, these old guys that have these old wrecking yards, they're pretty cool old guys, you know, and they do it. They have a passion for what they do. And it's not about the money. It's, you know, of course, it's about the money to make their ends meet and put food on their table. But it's more than that. And that's what's really cool. You know, it's, you know, nobody's pushing. And you can't even call these guys. You got to show up. They don't even answer their phones. So that tells you they're not really hungry for money, you know. And that's what's really cool about that. But, you know, that's, I thought that was interesting, you know. And getting back to Financial Time Ministries, in Atlanta, and that was I hope I just said it. Larry Cadet, Cadet, I think. Yeah. And Financial Ministries. You know, he said, "Be a good steward to your money." And then getting back to where I started turning over my life, you know, and I started being frugal, watching my P's and Q's, you know, not buying an expensive pair of dingo boots, buying something from Kmart or, you know, that was second, as long as it didn't hurt my feet, you know. And that was it, you know. And I didn't go out and buy fancy stuff that I didn't need. And I learned to live within my means. And that's it. And that's in God we trust. That's being a good steward to my money, you know. And I trust the Lord, oh, no doubt. And I tithe. And even on a fixed income that I have today, and then a lot of times, okay, do I tithe my Social Security benefits? Well, that was already earned. You know, I already earned that. I already paid, just like, but no, I still do it. I still trust the Lord with my money, and I trust the Lord with my life. How's that? So that's what my video is about today. You know, I'll tell you what, there is a lot of things important today. And I know you've always heard this, you know, my Lord Jesus Christ, my wife, you know, I better say that, huh? My children, I love them. And I love my kids, my family, you know, my friends. Oh, yeah. My country. God bless America. Amen. And you folks, you know what? Take good care of yourself. You hear?